Okay, so I haven't rambled on to you guys for a bit, so I thought that I would. I'm fighting a little bit of pain the last few days. Part of it's because I ran out of coffee and I just haven't wanted to go to a store. The store that I used to go to, where there was hardly any people and I could go in and go out fast, that store closed down. So now I'm stuck with the Walmart Superstore and the Smith's like Superstore. The problem with those, the Smith's, it's nice, but okay, you got produce here and you got the milk all the way. You gotta go all the way to the back of the store and go all the way almost to the other end. So they have things all spread out. And I know why, so they can sell more stuff, but for someone like me, it just doesn't work. And I don't, why is this light flashing? Is the battery dead? Let me check. No, it's getting lower though. All right, so, yeah. And I don't dare really put myself in the scooters because I gotta concentrate too much to operate the scooters. I'm not kidding. So, but I thought I'd share with you a few things that I have found that I'm really liking. Okay, this one's just, okay, this one's a wooden frock, right? This was back around Christmas time when I got this. It just for shits and giggles, but I've come to really like it. So, you run this across there. The rest of my family finds it annoying, but sometimes it just, I lay in bed and do it, and I don't know, I just enjoy it. I got, and my grandbaby loves it too, my youngest grandbaby, so I got him a really big one. I'm sure my son appreciates that. And then I found this Pacifica perfume, which is all natural, and this is Himalayan patchouli berry. And all I smell is the patchouli, so it works for me. I like it. The only, well, it could be considered a problem. It's all natural, so that's cool. But the bottle costs like $20. And, you know, you see the size of it. But that wouldn't be so much a problem, but since it's all natural, I don't know, it seems like if you could get a condensed oil, it would let the, where you could put it on like once a day, so, and it would stay on there longer, that would be good, because the smell seems to dissipate on this, and you gotta reapply it. So, that's the only problem I have with it, but I really like it, and I'll keep using it, and I like the rose one too, and then there's a vanilla one, but the vanilla one, you smell like a bakery, which is fine, but not in the summertime for me, so I'll use it in the wintertime. Then I found these teas. They're dessert teas, and one's vanilla bean macaroon, and that's black tea. Has a black tea confection with notes of fragrant vanilla and a dash of cinnamon. Now, this one I have with a spoon full of honey and then some vanilla almond milk. It's delicious. And since I've ran out of coffee, that's what I'm drinking now. Then the other one is glazed lemon loaf. And it is an herbal tea. An enticing herbal infusion with notes of bright lemon and creamy vanilla. Okay, this one here, you don't taste the lemon so much. It's like, tastes like vanilla frosting. I kid you not. It's that strong. And there's no caffeine in that one. But I think that one would be nicer if I put more milk in it. It's a little strong for me. So, I don't know. But I mean, it's good, but it's a little bit strong. Like I said, it's like frosting. hair in my teeth. So, for on the myelogic encephalomyelitis front, yeah, like I said, I've been having that pain. I'm not sure how much is associated with brewing that coffee, but anyways, the caffeine is helping this morning. And then this starts acting up. You know how it goes. But I'll survive. Work through it like I always do. And hopefully get under control before it goes weeks and I have to go to physical therapy. But I know how to do all those exercises. So usually I don't have to go to physical therapy anymore. Oh, these pants, they're the pants I was getting for my daughter. She's 16 now. And they're Old Navy, and they're the jeggings, but they have pockets. They could be deeper, but they have actual pockets. And then I can get them long, because my daughter's, anyway, she's tall. She don't want me to tell you how tall. So I get the length that I get for her. Actually, these are pants I got for her. She says they're a little too big. And they're really comfy. I'm finding that they're really comfy. So they're Old Navy. And I can only get this length online, which works out fine. But the prices went up on them. So, see, they're just plain pockets. Anyways, I'm trying to think what else. Oh, some of my medications are starting to not work, and that's not really cool, because, yeah, it's something I don't want to discuss, so I can't discuss it on here. I would discuss it with a small group of people who understand, but not, I'm not going to post it online, but anyways, it's just one of those medications where it's an ordeal to, if you have to get off of it. I don't know if there's much options or not. It's cold. It was 87 like 2 days ago, and then now it's, I don't know what it is, but it's cold. You have all seasons in Utah. And one day, ay, ay, ay. I've been doing my legs like concrete, but on my better days, I have been doing, working with those gardens in my yard, you know, garden as in food with perennials in it. And then my son decided he wanted to plant corn, so my perennial bed I was working on along the fence, I put that on hold and let him put corn in there. So we'll see what happens with that. I told him there's still going to be some perennials coming up, but they'll be fine with the corn. And then I have this triangle that I, you know, the neighbors and I wanted to pull the grass out. They all want to put concrete in, but you cannot. You don't put concrete in. You can use it as a bed for medicinals and for food. That's asinine to put concrete in. That's just my opinion. But so I've been working on that, and that's cottage style. I put every flowering medicinal seed in there that I had, and some creeping flowering thyme, which I haven't ever planted that until now. So we'll see how that goes. Right now, it's like, what's the name? I can't think of the proper name for the flowering carrot. It's like maidenhair or something. Maiden. Anyways, it has the big white, like the way dill is on top, but it's white instead of, like, anyways. You see, cognitive issues. And then the park strip. Is if I can get the lavender to grow, usually it just goes crazy, and it doesn't need good soil, but anyways, that's just been a bit of work, you know, in the spring and in the fall, it's always a bit of work, but it's good therapy. I don't paint when I, you know, because it takes all my energy to work outside, so I don't usually paint. I don't know if I ever really paint. I guess I do if I feel like it, but yeah, when I'm gardening, I'm usually not painting because, you know, you only have this much energy. Do you guys want a video of the bed so far, or do you want me to wait until the antique roses are blooming? I don't know. Do you want a video at all? I'm not making many videos, and I'm not actually online as much as I used to because it's just not fun anymore, but I still have the Raise Emmy Awareness Facebook page, and I'm still doing that. Sorry, I'm just keep rubbing my head, you know? I still have my regular Facebook page, but the thing I've been doing, if I'm not outside and if my internet will work on my touchscreen phone, which, by the way, you cannot carry these SOBs around when you're gardening, and if, what are you going to do if you need to use it anyways? My hands are covered in mud and dirt, so I leave in the house so nobody can get a hold of me. I check when I come in, but that doesn't work for me, you know, it's like, when I owned a landscaping business, I could never have that shiz. It would have had to stay in the truck, which actually most of the time my phones did stay in the truck, so, but I like the flip one back, that, you know, that's what worked. Got sidetracked. Anyways, it's raining today, so I can't make a video today showing you, and the I can't think of the name now. The flowering bulbs, all that's blooming now is the later tulips, the daffodils. They're done blooming. But you can see pictures on my Instagram, which is just Dana McClarion. All that's on my Instagram is my art and my beds, my flower beds, and just more artistic stuff, like when I'm playing with the photography programs that I could load on my phone. My phone doesn't hold the internet and stuff, but you can't complain because that's still the Obama phone, and they sent it to me for free, so I'm not going to complain at all, but I was hoping they were going to send me just a, you know, not a touch screen, just a little. But welcome to the 21st century, huh? But, so that's what's on there is, you know, me playing with some programs. So once again, I'm my only model unless it's flowers. And the programs I've found, I haven't really figured out how to make them work with anything other than faces. And my daughter doesn't like having herself out there, but one picture of her, because she's like, okay, I'm into this actor right now, right? And so then she goes, he's in Riverdale. So, and that is so not my kind of show. I hate that where people are all backstabbing and lying. I just hate that. But she goes, I'll watch it with you because I like it. So I'm sitting here, and I was in bed, mind you, before. And so I get up and I'm sitting here, and she lays down on the couch and goes to sleep. She watches it for a little bit, but then she's asleep. I'm like, yeah, it didn't help my headache, and he wasn't in it enough to make it worse. Wow, I'm thinking, I'm watching a show right now that has him in it, so I'm going to go through, it's like when I goes on the Jared Leto thing, you know, so go through and find movies that they're in, see if there's anything I like. And then I might go back to Riverdale and just fast forward to where he's at, because the storyline drives me crazy. I know, I'm such a loon, huh? Oh well, I am what I am. But the Instagram, like I said, is more garden and artsy, but I'll still throw up pictures of my books. But I'm trying to not put up so many pictures of me unless it's an artistic thing, but I don't know. I'm random, I'm gonna be Dana. But there's no quotes or anything. There's no reposts. That's what's good about Instagram. You can't, don't tell me how. I don't know how to repost anything, which is good, because then it makes it all original stuff. Yeah. But that's what I'm doing. I don't know how people can do all this online stuff or why. I guess if it helps for business, then you do. I don't have energy and it's not that exciting to me, but I enjoy some of the stuff on Instagram and I like it, like I said, for my art stuff and my cottage style gardening. I found there's people on there who do the same stuff as me. But Instagram keeps bugging me, saying that I need to make it a business profile. What the hell? It's not like I'm rolling in dough from my paintings or my gardening. Hello, I'm disabled. I gave up the one flower bed that I was doing. Because on top of my small yard, that was too much. So it's like, are you kidding me, Instagram, really? And they keep saying, they send me things, finish making yours a business account, because you have businesses following you and your account, you know, looks like a business account. I guess I can take that as a compliment. But it's such a joke. I haven't done a painting for a while because all I have is the roll of canvas, and I have given up on trying to stretch any canvas. I suck. They look terrible when I tried to stretch them. Nope. So if I do stuff on loose canvas, it's just staying loose canvas. And I'll hang it on the wall that way. But if somebody wants to buy it, they're just going to have to buy it as a loose canvas, and they can do what they want with it, you know. But it's not like all these people are wanting to buy my paintings, which is fine. That's not why I do it. It's my therapy, like the gardening. Alright, well, I don't know if you guys missed my rambling, but here you go, in case you needed a Dana fix of my rambling. You're welcome. Alright. Hugs and loves all. I'll talk to you later. I'm still alive. Well, I'm dead, but I'm still alive.